Good evening. Good evening. Okay. So once again, we would like to welcome you to our encounter series. So this will be 8 nights, starting tonight and until next week. So hopefully, after this, like what Ma'am said a while ago said, after this experience, after this encounter, we'll never be the same again. Okay, and also we would like to welcome those who are listening online. So, as we study the Word of God, we are inviting you as well to open your Bible with us, and we will together encounter Jesus this whole week. So let's pray again. Heavenly Father, once again, we would like to praise you and thank you for this opportunity. We would like to pray, Lord, that may you help us and give us a humble and teachable heart, that we may receive your words as it is. May change us, O Lord, in Jesus' name. Amen. Okay, so because our time is too fast, so we will be starting already our topic this evening. But before that, I would like to tell you a story. When I was in my canvassing requirement, so because our canvassing work in College of Theology is a required subject, so when we were in Bulacan, where we had our canvassing work for 4 months, that was last year, 2015, from, that is the transition period of our school from a regular high school to K-12. So we had our canvassing work for 4 months. So that was April, May, June, and July. Now, interestingly, we went to a place in part of Bulacan that is DRT. I cannot remember anymore the meaning of DRT. But when we were there, that was, I think, April. So imagine that is summer. No? That was summer that time. And when we were there, we found out that there's only one source of water. Aside from their manual pump, in Tagalog Poso, the other source of their water is only one well, balon. And because that was summer, imagine, that was summer, the well is turning to dry. I mean, because there is no more, and I think that well is only dependent on the rain. No, so because there is no rain that time, first the water or the well is turning to dry, and there's no water at that well. So what happened? Because we need to, of course, we are doing our canvassing work, we are selling books. We're inviting people to sell to buy books from us. We need also to take a bath. What happened is, when we were there, when we found out that there's no water at the well, and there's a little bit, very little amount of water, what we are doing, we get water from it, and because we are many in a group, what we are doing, someone will stand. And the other one will sit beside him, and as he, you know, paano ba explain yun? Pag binuhos niya yung tubig, so alam niyo na, di ba? Pag binuhos niya yung tubig, yung isa, nadadamay din. So what we are doing, we just get water from that well, and after taking the first person, after he take a bath, of course, the other person will also receive the water coming from him. So that's what we are doing, and it's a terrible thing, but we don't have any choice but to do that because there's no water. However, in contrary, there's this one experience that we had at Batarasa, Batarasa, Palawan. If you had been there, that is one of the beautiful places in Palawan. So this is the picture. So it's nakikita niyo ba sa likod? Ayan. This part, if you can see that part, that is a well. A well did because the wave coming from the sea covers this well. So therefore, the logic there, the well or the water should be salty, right? But when I took a water coming from it and I tasted it, amazingly, that water is drinkable. Really, it's drinkable. And I tasted it, I drank from it, and I can witness, I can testify that water is drinkable. Now, to really make sure the reason why even though the water coming from the sea covers that well, but still that well is drinkable, I tried to put my hand under that well or inside the well, and I found out that the source, the water, is too strong coming from the source. So meaning to say, as the water coming from the sea covers it, the water coming from the well, because the overflow, that the flow is too strong, mas natatalo niya yung water coming from the sea. And I realize that same story is the same with our spiritual life. The first story that we had in Bulacan might tell us that if we do not have the source, the proper source, we will turn into a dry well and we will never be a blessing to other people. But if we have that right source, even though there will be a lot of worldly influence, there will be a lot of secular influence, but because we have that right source, we can strongly go against those influences and we can be a blessing to other people. Amen? This evening, we will be studying a certain or particular story in the Bible which talks about a well. Our topic this evening is entitled, Quench. Encounter at the well. It is found in John chapter 4, verse 1 until verse 45. So if you have your Bibles with you, you can open with me, but I will be projecting to you the verses coming from the Bible or from our story. I'll be reading it coming from English Standard Version or ESV. Quench. Some of you here have heard already the story of the Samaritan woman at Samaria. John chapter 4. I think you heard it many times already, but I'll be just giving you this evening three observations, then after that, we're done. Okay? So hopefully, you will be attentively listen as we study chapter 4 of John. Let's go with the first verse. It says here, "Now when Jesus learned that the Pharisees had heard that Jesus was making and baptizing more disciples than John." So the context or the story behind the story of chapter 4 is in chapter 3, John the Baptist is baptizing people and his disciples are baptizing people and also the disciples of Jesus Christ. Then after that instance, the disciples of John are trying to tell John, Rabbi or teacher, the disciples of Jesus Christ are baptizing more people than us. So there is this sort of competition between the disciples of Jesus and the disciples of John the Baptist. Now, when Jesus heard that the Pharisees had that news that they are baptizing more people than the disciples of John, what Jesus did is he went away from the place of Judea. From what place? Judea. Now, let's go to the next verse. Chapter 4, verse 3 to 4. He left Judea. Okay, he left Judea and departed again for what place? Galilee. and he had to pass through Samaria. Now, this is interesting because this word connotes that he needs to pass through Samaria. Meaning to say, it is not the usual way from Judea going to Galilee, it's not the usual way to pass through Samaria. Are you getting the point? Actually, if you're going to read the original language of it, that is Greek, of course we are studying Greek in College of Theology, if you're going to study the Greek word of that, it means he traversed. Now we are doing our hiking, in Master Guide we are doing our hiking. When we say traverse, it is making another way aside from the usual way. So when we hike a mountain, of course, we came from the drop-off, and when we hike the mountain and we pass the usual way, and when, as we go down, we pass another way, we call that traverse. So when Jesus went from Judea going to Galilee, he traversed the way. Instead of passing the usual way, he passed through Samaria. Interesting, right? Next verse. So he came to a town of Samaria called Sychar, near the field that Jacob had given to his son Joseph. And verse 38, I think. Hindi ako makamali. Next verse. Sige po. 46. So he came again to Cana in Galilee, where he had made the water wine. So meaning to say, he came from Judea, going to Galilee, particularly the place of Cana, and he passed through Samaria. Now, let's look them up. So you can understand the concept or the context or the story. Most likely, Jesus came from this place. This is Jordan, part of Jordan River. Now, the usual way and the fastest way is the red line. Can you see the red line? And that is Cana. But what Jesus did is, he went this way, or he went that way, and he went here, Sychar, that is Samaria. That is longer. But why is it that Jesus need to pass through Samaria? Know the answer? First point, first observation. Jesus intended to come to Samaria. For what reason? It's not an accident. It is not a coincidence. It is an encounter that he intentionally made for that Samaritan woman. I tell you this evening, Jesus intentionally came on this earth just to personally encounter you. Just to personally encounter you. Second point. Jacob's well was there. So Jesus, what? Word as he was from his journey, was sitting beside the well. So therefore, Jesus is so tired at time. And actually, if you're going to read verse 6, I did not put the whole verse. The next sentence says, that was about 6th hour of the day. And in our time, that is 12 o'clock at noon. So meaning to say, Jesus Christ is not only tired at time, but he is also what? Hungry. Because that is already lunchtime. And that's why the Bible is telling us that as he stopped at that well, his disciples went to buy some food. Next verse says, a woman from Samaria came to draw water. Jesus said to her, give me a drink. Give me a drink. Imagine, Jesus, the Creator, Jesus who created the well, the spring of waters, the sea, the rivers, the one who created water itself is asking for a drink. And what the woman said, let's continue. The Samaritan woman said to him, how is it that you, a Jew, ask for a drink from me, a woman of Samaria? Why? Because the reason, Jews have nothing to do with Samaritans. Why? Because they have this long time quarrel with each other because of a particular story. So we will not study that story anymore. But the point is, they do not have any connection with the Samaritans. The Jews with the Samaritans. So what happened? Jesus said to him, or to her. Next. Jesus answered her, if you knew the gift of God and who it is that is saying to you, give me a drink. Okay? Next verse. You would have asked him and he would have given you living water. So Jesus is telling to her, if you only know the one who is asking you the water, and if you ask him to give you as well a water, he will give you the living water. Now, the Samaritan woman, think for a while. And logically, he asked a question to Jesus. And what was that question? She said, first, everyone who drinks of this water will be thirsty again. Next verse. But whoever drinks of the water that I will give him will never be thirsty again. So what the woman said? The water that I will give him will become in him a spring of water welling up to eternal life. Next verse. Jesus said to her, go. I think we have, we miss a verse. We miss a verse. Okay, let's go to our Bible. John chapter 4. John chapter 4. Okay, in verse 7, it says here, a woman from Samaria came to draw water, and Jesus said to her, give me a drink. Then verse 8, verse 9, the Samaritan woman said to him, logically, how is it that you, a Jew, ask for a drink from me, a woman of Samaria? And verse 10, Jesus answered her, if you knew the gift of God and who it is saying to you, give me a drink, you would have asked him and he would have given you living water. Verse 11, the woman said to him, sir, you have nothing to draw water with, and the well is deep. Where do you get the living water? Logically, the woman is asking her, or asking him, you don't have anything as an instrument to draw water coming from that well, and now you are saying that I can give you, or you can give me, a living water. So the woman is very logical. But Jesus said to him, verse 13, Jesus said to her, everyone who drinks of this water will be thirsty again. But whoever drinks of the water that I will give him will never be thirsty again. The woman said to him, sir, give me this water so that I will not be thirsty or have to come here to draw water. Of course, because Jesus told her that he will give her a living water, of course, logically, if I be in the place of that woman and I used to get water from that well and I used to get tired because of getting water from that well, and I don't want anymore to get tired. I would rather have that living water than to get water coming from that well. So the woman is telling Jesus, sir, give me that living water so I will never be thirsty again. Jesus said to her, go call your husband and come here. Friends, when Jesus told that woman that everyone who drinks from the water of that well will be thirsty again, Jesus is not only telling about that water coming from that well. Jesus is telling something that is deeper than that literal well. Jesus is telling to this woman, there are something in this world that you used to drink. But as you used to drink these things, you used to thirst also. You are never being satisfied by what you are drinking. And so therefore, this woman is asking Jesus, thinking that he is telling about the literal well, Lord, give me that living water. But Jesus said to him, go call your husband and come here. And what did the woman say to him? Sir, Jesus, or sir, I have no husband. And Jesus said to her, you're right in saying, I have no husband. Why? Because, next verse says, you have had five husbands, and the one you now have is not your husband. What you have said is true. Then when the woman heard that, she was shocked. How did this man know that my husband right now is not actually my legitimate husband, and I had five husbands before? Then this woman understood that Jesus is not telling the literal, is not talking about the literal well, but Jesus is telling her that you used to drink water coming from your husband, from people around you, from the expectations coming from this world. You used to drink coming from the things of this world, but you were never satisfied. Why? Because there is only one way for you to be satisfied, and that is to drink the living water. To drink the living water. And what happened? The woman said to him, I know that the Messiah is coming. When he comes, he will tell us all things. Then what Jesus said, I who speak to you, am he. And the very time, at that time when Jesus said to him, the Messiah is no other than me, than I, then the woman, what happened to the woman? The woman that the next verse says, verse 28. So the woman left her what? Left her what? Water jar and went away into town and said to the people, come see a man who told me all that I ever did. Can this be the Christ? The woman who is very thirsty at that time, who came to that well just to take the water coming from that well, now left her water jar because at the moment Jesus told her that I am the Messiah, she recognized that the Messiah is no other than the living water he's telling a while ago, and that living water satisfied her. Friends, second point. The first point a while ago, he what? Intended to come, and now he invited her to drink. Friends, this evening, as we start our encounter series, I would like to tell you this evening, Jesus is inviting you to drink from him. And even drink Jesus Christ himself. There are a lot of things in this world that we thought will satisfy us. Relationships. Maybe some of us here had a lot of broken relationships already. Not even boyfriend. Families. Maybe you came from a broken society. You had been, I don't know, an addict before. You have that broken life. Thinking that these things in this world will satisfy you. But Jesus is inviting us this evening. Come. Drink me. I am the living water. And if you drink me, I will satisfy you. And actually, as I satisfy you, you will never stop on coming me because you want to drink more. Are you still going to let this world satisfy you when in fact the world can never satisfy you? Are you going to let Jesus enter your life and let him satisfy your desire? Third observation, and we're done. Next verse, it says here, Jacob's well was there, so Jesus, the verse that we read a while ago, Jesus, where does he was from his journey, was sitting beside a well. And the time is, next verse. It was about the what? 6th hour. 12 noon. Now, Jesus is hungry. He needs some food. But when Jesus met that woman after the encounter, interestingly, after the encounter, this is what had happened. John chapter 4, verse next, 31. Meanwhile, the disciples were urging him, saying, Rabbi, what? Eat. What Jesus said to them. Wala yung verse. Okay. Jesus said to them, chapter 4, but I said John, chapter 4, sorry. Chapter 4, verse 31, Rabbi, eat. But he said to them, I have food to eat that you do not know about. Then disciples was confused. Then, has anyone brought him something to eat? Then Jesus told them. Jesus said to them, my food is to do the will of him who sent me and to accomplish his work. Verse 34. 39. And this is the will of him. John chapter 6, verse 39. And this is the will of him who sent me, that I should lose nothing of all that he has given me. Next verse. For this is the will of my Father, that everyone who looks on the Son and believes in him should have eternal life. Friends, When Jesus met that woman, it is not only the woman who was satisfied, but Jesus himself. Because Jesus, third observation, identified her as his own. I fully believe, right now this evening, Jesus would like to have that same encounter with you. And the next nights, still the same. Jesus would like to have a personal encounter with you. And the very reason why he would like to have that encounter with you is because of this. He identified you as his own. His will is for you to save and to be with him eternally. John Doom said, there will be a day when you find him unexpectedly at the well of your deepest thirst. And I know, maybe this evening is your first time to hear this, and this is the time that your deepest thirst has been satisfied by the one who owns the living water. May we all be quenched this evening by having personal encounter with him.